Good morning, all of you. Today, we are going to continue our chapter 10, Money in Everyday Life. Today, we will discuss about the bills. So, bills in your daily life, when you buy something from the supermarkets or any type of market, the shopkeeper will provide you the bill. In the bill, all the details are there. What are the quantities you are What are the items you have purchased, how much quantity is there, what is the cost and what is the amount. And through this, all the things are written over there, and below there is a total of all the things and all the amount. And then the important thing is that ki how much money you have paid. Suppose amount is of 500, that the bill is of 500 and you have given the 1,000 rupees, so the amount which is written is also written in the bill, and the money you are paying is also written in the bill. So today, student, we are discussing about the bill. Now there is a bill of a copy in front of you. I am showing you the bill copy. So this is your bill. This is your bill which is shown in front of you. So in this bill, what we have, a variety store is there, central market is there, rice quantity is 5 kg, rate is 50 and the cost is of 250. Next is sugar 2 kg, rate 40, cost 80. So total amount we have 330. So this is the type example of what a bill. Now student, we are going to discuss on our topic bill in exercise 10.4 of your bill of your book. In front of you, Delhi market displays the supermarket prices. In front of you, this is the market price which is shown in the book of yours, exercise 10.4. So with this, sugar 30 rupee per kg, butter 90 rupee per kg. So all these amounts are in of what? Kgs, per kgs. Soap is in per cake, tomatoes is there, potatoes is there, cabbage is there, bananas are in dozen, apples 10 rupee each, means one apple is to be each, pencil 80 rupee per dozen, notebook 120 rupee per dozen. In a dozen we have 12 quantities. Pen 10 rupee each, toothpaste 27 rupee each, light bulb 60 rupee each, shirting 120 rupee per meter, means the costing is of 1 meter equals to 120 rupee. Biscuits 220 per kg, milk is in liter 32 rupees per liter, pastries per dozen 108 rupees per dozen, sweets are there 80 rupee per kg, bread is there 150 rupee per loaf, ice cream 20 rupee each. So these are the some item prices. Now we have a question number 1. Kishore's bill when shopping at the supermarket. So he has taken all these quantities, soap 3 quantities, rate amount total 45, sugar 1 kg, rate 30 rupees, amount 30, butter half kg 90 rupees, amount 45, tomato half kg rupees 10, amount 5, milk 2 liters, rate 32 rupees per liter, and amount he have to pay 64 rupees. So total he have given of rupees 189, and total amount he have paid 189. This is your first question of exercise 10.4. We are doing the exercise 10.4 question. Now, what did he get back? So, he have given rupees 500. And amount for the bill rupees 189. Cash back, he get back, you have to minus 500 minus rupees 189. So when you minus rupees 189, you get the answer rupees 311. Now in this way we can do the question. The second thing, students, suppose if the cost is given to you, suppose a cost is there, 220 rupee per kg, and if he will ask you to find out the cost of 500 grams, you have to find out the cost. Simply what you have to do, you have to multiply 220 multiply 0.5. when you convert into kg, when you convert this 500 gram into kg, we all know 1 kg equals to 1000 gram, and 1 gram equals to 1 upon 1000 kg. So 500 grams equals to 500 divided by 1000. So we got the answer 0.5 kg. So when the kg price is given to you, and suppose you have to find the 500 gram, so you have to first convert it into kg, and then you can easily multiply it. When you multiply 220 multiply by 5 0 10 1 11, 0.1, after one decimal you have to use, after one digit you have to use the point. So what you got the answer? 110 rupee. So student, in this way you can convert, or you can find out the values of each and every gram that is given in the question. So it will become easier for you. So find out the question, so find out the answer, the question, if the question says you have to find out the 300 grams, you have to find out the 400 grams amounts, you have to find out the 500 grams amounts, you have to find out the 750 grams amounts. In this way you can easily find out the price. This will make you easier. Now student, I am doing the second question of exercise 10.4. Calculate the cost of the purchase below. What change would you receive in each case if you give the cashier 500 rupees? Means I am making the bill and 500 rupees is given to the cashier. Rest of the amount will be change received back will be shown. So first I am prepared the bill. This is the B part. And first question I am doing. So I am first drawing the bill. This is your first question. 300 gram coffee. Prices is given on the upper side. 200 grams biscuits. 750 pulses, 1 kg potatoes. Rate is given to you, coffee rate 450 rupees per kg, biscuits 220 rupees per kg, pulses 80 rupees per kg, and potatoes 6 rupees per kg. Now you have to find out the amount. In the amount, In the amount, what you have to write 300 gram. See, amount will be written as it is. You don't need to do any type of, you have don't need to show any type of multiplication. Means, suppose 300 gram of coffee, you have to find the rate of 300 gram. But here the rate is given to you is of per kg. How you find the 300 gram coffee rate? In the rough work, what you have to do, 300 multiply 450 multiply by 0.3. As we discussed earlier, 1 kg, 1 gram equals to 1 upon 1000 kg, 300 grams equals to 300 upon 1000 kg. So it will show you 0.3 kg. So here 450 multiply by 0.3 kg. When 450 multiply by 0.3 kg, you got the answer 135 rupees. So all these calculation can be done in the rough. You know, no need to show these type of calculations in this amount. 200 kg biscuits means 220 multiply by how much? 220 multiply by 0.2. So you got the answer 44. 750, 80 multiply by 0.750. So you got the answer 60. And 1 kg of potato is given as it is. All these are prices in rupees. So even you don't use, it is all automatically shown that it is in the amount, means it is in the rupees. When you add, so here when you add this, you got the total. Total, and below this, what change received back. Total is of 245 rupees, and 500 minus 245, you got answer 255. So this cash back amount is, the cash change received back is 255. In this way we can do the first question. Now sir, we are going to do the second question of this exercise 10.B part 2. Just I have to remove all these items list. Rate list. But you have to draw a fresh table for the fresh questions. So all the amount work for the calculation work will be done in the rough work. 500 grams butter, 2 loaves, 6 ice creams, 300 gram butter. So, 300 gram butter, it is a sweet. 500, what is the price of sweet? Sweets are of 80 rupees per kg. Bread, 15 rupees per loaf. Ice creams, 20 rupees of each. And butter we have 90 rupees per kg. Now in this, what we have to do, 80 multiply by 0.5, because this 500 gram is divided into kg. So we have converted into kg, and then 80 multiply by 0.5, so we got the answer rupee 40. Two loaves of bread means 15 is multiplied by 2. We got the answer 30 rupee. Six ice cream. So 20 multiplied by 60 rupees, 120. 300 grams means 90 rupees multiplied by 0.3. So we get the answer 27. When we all the amount, the total amount we receive 217 rupees, and 500 is change given to the shopkeeper. So 500 minus 217, we got 280 rupees. So in this way, we can do this type of question. Now, student, what is the homework for today? Do question A, question B, and question C of exercise 10.4. You have to do question A, question B, and question C of exercise 10.4. That's all for today. Thank you, students.